Hello, Windows Universe. In this video, we will look at how you can fix your taskbar if it has become unclickable. For a more in-depth look at the subject, be sure to check out the link in the description. Let's try restarting the File Explorer. You're going to have to open the Task Manager by pressing Ctrl, Alt, and Delete. And once the Task Manager opens up, look for Windows Explorer, right-click on it, and select Restart. Once it restarts, try clicking on the taskbar and see if the problem has been resolved. Let's run a troubleshooter and see if this solves the problem. Open a run box by pressing the Windows key and R. Type in percentage sign system root percentage sign slash system 32 slash msdt dot exe space hyphen id space maintenance diagnostic, all one word. Then click OK. Click on Next. This might also be a problem with your display driver, so let's check out our graphics driver. Open the Device Manager. To do that, you'll press Windows key and X, then go to Device Manager. Go to your graphics drivers, right-click. If the problem happened after a driver update, you can see if you can roll back the driver. So let's go to Properties. Go to Driver. If you have the ability to roll back, go ahead. If not, click on Update Driver. Search automatically for drivers. Then restart your system and see if that works. You can also download the latest drivers from the manufacturer's website. After that, restart and check and see if the problem has been resolved. Next, we can run a DISM. This will identify and fix any problem with the system image. You'll have to open the command prompt as an administrator. To do that, open the run box, type in cmd.exe, and press Control, Shift, and Enter. Then type in DISM.exe space slash online space slash cleanup image space slash restore health and hit enter. This might take a few minutes depending on the level of image corruption. After it runs, restart your system and see if the problem has been corrected. Finally, you can try a system restore. To do this, you'll have to open a run box, type in RSTRUI, and click OK. Click Next. Pick a restore point from before the problem began. It will restore your system. It should remove the problem. The downside is any programs installed before that time will need to be reinstalled. This can also be a good thing because then you can reinstall these programs one at a time and see if one of these programs causes the problem. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.